Hello and welcome to our introductory school video. We hope that you find this video informative and helpful in your decision-making process as to where to send your children in September when they start school. So St Philip's is a Church of England school. We have a Christian ethos that underpins all our life in school and how we work together. We have 280 children in our school and they are divided into 9 classes. Now each year we can take 40 children into the reception year group, and for those places parents must apply to the local authority, and that application needs to be in before midnight on January the 15th. You'll have to list 3 school preferences in your application form. Now the way that works, if only 40 people were to apply for St Philip's Primary School, then everybody would be given a place, regardless of where they live. If, however, more than 40 people apply to St Philip's, then preference is given in the following order. First of all, preference is given to children in foster care, and secondly, preference is given to those children who have siblings in the school already. Thirdly, children of staff working in the school. And lastly, the remaining places are offered starting with those who live nearest, based on your postcode, door to door from the school, and preference is given to the nearest children. Now, as I said, each year we can take 40 children into school, but we don't have classes of 40, so that means that we have mixed year groups through the school. And to start with, the children are grouped according to their age. But as we get to know the children further through the school, this is based on ability. The school's broken into 2 different phases. We've got the infant phase and the junior phase, or Key Stage 1 and Key Stage 2, it's sometimes called. So the infant phase, or Key Stage 1, is Robin class, and that's reception. And J class, that's a mixture of reception and year 1 children. In Dove class, we have year 1 and year 2, and Nightingale class, just year 2 children. Then in the junior department, we have Hawk class, which is just year 3s. Eagle class is a mixture of year 3s and 4s. Osprey class is a mixture of 4s and 5s. Owl class is a mixture of 5 and 6, and Kestrel class is just year 6s. There are thousands of values we could have chosen, but we've picked these 7 as we feel they are the most important and underpin our school life. So love, respect, forgiveness, honesty, hope, perseverance and kindness. Now we'll take you through some pictures of the school, starting on the infant playground. We have 2 playgrounds, one for the infants and one for the juniors. So all our infant children share this playground here. And as we work our way through the classes, we have Robin class. This is where our youngest 30 children would go into Robin class. J class, this will be the mixture of reception children and year ones, right next door to Robin. Dove class would be the year one and year two mixed class, and Nightingale will be just year twos. Then we have the junior department. This is the junior playground. Hawk class, just year threes. Eagle class, a mixture of year 3s and year 4s. Osprey class, a mixture of year 4s and year 5s. Owl class, year 5 and year 6. And lastly, Kestrel class, it's just year 6s. These are the staff that would be working with the reception children when they first join the school. So in Robin class, we have Mrs. Thompson and Mrs. Whitfield. And Miss Holder will teach in J class. And a team of TAs, Mrs. Sinclair, Mrs. Isaacs, Mrs. Kay, and Mrs. Frayling, a very able team of teaching assistants that support learning through those 2 classes.
In EYFS, we feel it's really important for the children to play inside and outside of the classroom, experimenting for themselves and making links in their own play. Over the next few slides, you will see some of the things that we get up to within our classroom. The children have the opportunity to play inside and outside of the classroom on a free flow system.
I like driving the car.
I like playing with the cars. Playing with the water is fun.
I like playing in the castle.
I love playing with the milkman.
I like playing with the Play-Doh.
I like getting messy.
Role play is really important in EYFS. We try and change the role play corner as much as possible depending on the child's interest. Sometimes it's a shop, sometimes it's a pirate ship. We feel it's important to teach outside and inside the classroom to give the children as many different opportunities as possible. At the end of each topic, we like to have a big celebration day. The children come in, dressed up, and we have fun together consolidating our lovely topic. We feel it's really important to share different cultures in St. Philip's. We have so many children that come from different backgrounds, and we feel it's important that they get to share their information about their country and their traditions with all the children. In the classroom, we do a mixture of child-led and teacher-led activities. This is the teacher leading a Numicon activity in a practical, fun way. Teaching phonics at St. Philip's is really, really important. It's the foundation of being able to teach reading successfully. At our school, we focus on Read, Write, Ink by Ruth Miskin. Each day, the children take part in a phonics lesson, learning the basic sounds and blends. Each week, we take all the reception children on a welly walk to our local woods, which is just around the corner from our school. We go whatever the weather, rain or shine. The children just love it, exploring and finding out all things for themselves.
I like welly walks.
We like to invite as many different people into our school as possible, sharing their jobs and experiences. This is one of our dads bringing in his fire crew with him and showing the children all about the fire engine. They loved it. We love going on trips at St. Philip's. We like to do a trip every big term. We've been to lots of different places, but the farm trip is especially a favourite one of EYFS.
The farm trip is the best.
All of our teachers and TAs have very high standards of expectations for both behaviour and work across the school, and the children always live up to those expectations. Behaviour is very good throughout the school, and the standard of work is also very high. All of our children cook 3 times a year. We felt as a school that cooking was a life skill and therefore very important to learn. Whenever the children are cooking, there's always a wonderful smell that wafts down the corridors. We have a very able team of teaching assistants who work together with the class teacher. Much learning happens in the class, but there's also learning that happens out of class in small groups or sometimes one-to-one. We support all the children with their various needs. Some are more able and some are less able, and everyone is different and everyone has their different skills and abilities. We have a very broad range of subjects and activities at St. Philip's. Much of the morning is taken up with the traditional English and maths and reading skills, and the afternoons tend to be more orientated around topic work. Learning to use computers and technology is very important, a life skill indeed, and our school is well furnished. Each class has a set of iPads that they can use to support learning, and we have a very well furnished IT suite with 35 computers all networked, and the children enjoy using that space for their learning. We like to offer a broad range of extracurricular activities. Here the children are drumming, and drumming lessons with the peripatetic teacher from Bath North East Somerset Music Service, and sometimes it's drums, some years it's the recorder, other years it's been the ukulele. But we do believe that a broad experience is very important for the children. The next few slides you'll see the children engaging in a number of different extracurricular activities. We do believe that the broadest curriculum that we can offer children is the best curriculum. As part of the broad curriculum offer,
Our Year 4 children get to go on a one-night residential trip to Folly Farm, where they experience a number of different skills and fun activities. Pond dipping, fire lighting, shelter building, just to mention a few. Our Year 6 children get to go on a week's residential to Kilve Court, and they undertake a range of different activities: shooting, archery, high ropes, abseiling, climbing. And it's not just about those activities, it's also about character building, which is so important. That's a big thing for us at St Philip's, developing children's character, because it can be all sorts of things to all people, but having a great character is the most important thing in life. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. We hope that it's given you a small insight into our school and a feel for some of the things that we get up to at St Philip's. We're very sorry that we're not able to show you around as we have in the past, but we hope that you found this video a useful insight into our school.